you ever thought about integrating applications using simple and uniform web service interfaces? REST, or Representational State Transfer, is an architectural style that defines a way to make uniform API calls through RESTful web service interfaces. This allows for easy access of APIs implemented at the server end via the HTTP protocol. Client-server applications developed in any language, such as Java, can support REST to implement the Uniform Web Service interfaces. But do the Uniform Web Service interfaces work well in REST? Consider a traditional API library associated with customer and orders data. Let's say you have four APIs, one to add new customer details, one to retrieve the existing customer details, one to remove the existing customer details, and another to modify the existing customer details. These four APIs have to be exposed by your application. This makes your APIs difficult to use and less compatible with external client applications. With REST, the interfaces are designed so that the external user or client application can easily call the RESTful Uniform Web Service interface with less compatibility issues. For example, you could use a web application to web-enable those same four APIs to the external world by defining /customers as the RESTful web service interface. Any of the CRUD operations would be invoked at the client application URL in association with the respective HTTP verbs over the customer's uniform web service interface. With REST, representations of the resources that are transferred between client and server can use XML or YAML, but most commonly use JavaScript object notation, or JSON format. JSON is simple, lightweight data representation format with less metadata. This can be used to exchange data between software applications. Here, the structure of the JSON snippet specifies the HTTP methods, HTTP protocol, host server, and resource URL, followed by payload with data values, data objects, or both. And here, for JSON payload, the details are encapsulated in the JSON body tags. This JSON payload can be designed to be processed accordingly with the respective REST API call and sent to the host server in combination with any of the HTTP verbs. The different HTTP response codes are based on the type of HTTP request used. To create a new customer, let's make a POST request and send to the web application instance via the RESTful web service /customers, with the specific annotations along with the JSON payload. The JSON payload contains new customer details. The RESTful web service application returns the status code 201 to confirm new customer created. To retrieve existing customers, let's make a GET request and send to the web application instance via the RESTful web service /customers with the specific annotations. The output has the requested customer details in JSON format. The RESTful web service application returns the HTTP status code 200 to confirm the requested customer details are retrieved in the JSON format. To delete any existing customer details, let's make a delete request and send to the web application instance via the RESTful web service /customers with the specific annotations. The RESTful web service application returns the status code 204 to confirm the requested customer details are deleted in the backend, hence nothing showing in the output console. REST is an architectural style that defines a way to make uniform API calls through RESTful web service interfaces via HTTP protocol along with the suitable HTTP verbs. To learn about cloud standards such as SCIM, OAuth, and OpenID Connect, check out the other videos in the series. Thank you for watching.